my! Who was that?
The engines were shocked.
Astray, Donald! Gordon's getting faster and faster!
I don't think that was Gordon, Douglas.
Not another steamy.
A big, fast engine was racing through Sodor, and the engines were getting shocked as it ran past.
What was that?
Meanwhile, Spencer was talking to Burr when the signalman came out with a video camera.
Rattle my rods, it can't be!
It looks like it is, Spencer. But how?
Later that day, the engines were talking at Knapford Station.
That engine was fast, said Henry.
Not as fast as me, said Gordon.
Just then, the engine arrived. It was none other than the great Mallard. She had lovely blue and gold paint, and her rods were painted in nice shiny gold. The engines were shocked. They never expected to see the Mallard on Sodor.
Good morning, Sodor. I'm here for Christmas. I'm going to be this year's Santa engine.
Hello, Mallard. Welcome to Sodor. My name is Gordon, and I'm the fastest engine on this railway.
Why, hello, Gordon. I have heard an awful lot about you.
Oh my! Why, you don't say?
Why, I do say. You look a lot better than I expected, said the Mallard. I have finally met the rest of the famous Sodor engines.
It must have been a great honor breaking the world speed record, said Bogo.
Then Mallard gasped.
You are a Metropolitan Vickers, diesel electric type 2.
Why, yes I am, Mallard. Only two of us are left.
Really? Oh, I say.
If I wouldn't have come to this railway, I probably would have been scrapped.
You can say that again. I heard your class was completely useless, and you couldn't even run properly.
Boko was upset.
Now, Mallard, no need for that.
I know, but look at him. He's a failure, just like the rest of them diesels,
said the Mallard.
The thought of you befriending one of them things makes me sick to my boiler.
The engines were surprised. They never expected the Mallard to be so rude. Later that day, Mallard took a dislike to Edward. Edward was ready to leave with some trucks. And he was having problems. The trucks were playing tricks. And he couldn't start off.
Oh my! You are useless, Edward, aren't you? You can't even pull trucks.
Poor Edward was very embarrassed.
Why, you're Captain Service? I will never know, said the Mallard.
Don't speak to Edward like that.
Shut up, Diesel. I wasn't talking to you. Look at them trucks. I would never put one of my coupling chains on one of them dirty little things.
This made the trucks cross.
Dirty little things? We'll show her. On, Edward. On, on.
Then Mallard set off. That night in the sheds, the engines were talking about her, just as she arrived.
You know, my special train which starts tomorrow is completely sold out.
Good for you, said Edward.
The rest of the engines said nothing.
I'm going to make Sir Topham Hatt a lot of money. More money than you engines could ever make him.
Then she went to her shed.
Well, 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 if it ain't my sister, the Mallard. I haven't saw you in years.
You two seem very chatty this morning.
Who?
You and that Diesel.
Oh, you mean Bear. Oh, don't worry, he's okay.
What? He's a Diesel. None of them are okay. Not after what they did to us. There's only 7 of our class left, Spencer. The rest of them are all dead because of them Diesels taking over the railways.
Well, it's not all their fault, Mallard.
It is their fault for being built. I will never forgive them for what they did to our brothers and sisters. You're just as bad. While you were gallivanting around the world with the Duke and Duchess, we were all fighting for survival in the mainland as those Diesels started taking over our railways. Tomorrow, I will show them all when I go at my record-breaking speed again.
On the next day, the Mallard arrived at Knotford Station.
This is the day. Look at me, Edward. I'm going to break my record again.
You're not fit enough to break your record again, said Edward.
Oh, yeah? Just watch me, Edward. You're all just as bad as Spencer, you know. You's all set in this little island, as we had to fight for survival against the Diesels. You's have all had it easy.
Then the Mallard raced away. She was enjoying herself mostly. Then there was trouble. When she got to Gordon's Hill, she got slower and slower, and suddenly she stopped.
Dear, oh dear, what has happened to me?
Her driver applied the brakes.
You've broken down. I warned you about going too fast. And it's getting dark soon, too.
Oh no,
said the Mallard. And just then, Boko arrived.
Oh, Boko, please save me. I've broke down on the hill.
Well, I would, but I'm one of the old Metropolitan Vickers Diesels that are completely useless, aren't I?
And then Boko left.
What was I thinking of asking a Diesel?
Then Boko raced to the yards and found Edward.
Mallard has broken down on Gordon's Hill. Really? Right. I have proved myself to every engine on this island, time and time again, and I'm gonna prove myself to her as well.
And Edward raced to Gordon's Hill. Then he arrived.
Who's there?
It's me, Edward.
Oh, Edward, are you going to help me?
I'm going to help you, but I'm more worried about your passengers.
And then Edward started and helped the Mallard up the hill. It was dark by the time they arrived at the station. The Mallard was embarrassed. Just then, Edward pulled up beside her.
Mallard, I want to ask you something. Why were you so rude with us? What did we ever do on you?
Mallard told Edward about the Diesels. Edward smiled.
We've had problems on this island as well with Diesels.
Really?
Of course, but not all Diesels on this island are bad, Mallard.
Edward, I'm sorry. It's just that on the mainland when they were taking over, they were so wicked and cruel and laughed at us. I will never forget that.
I'm sure it was hard.
Would you accept my apology for all the engines? Please?
Why, of course.
But Edward didn't know if she included Boko or not.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle-belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer.